Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Perfect. So let me do the first part formally, because this is the only part that we do formally. You have seen her on many chat shows, conducting some, and also being a part of some. She is, I think, one of the most recognizable faces when it comes to where you've actually roasted people, and that the one that we remember the most is Roadies. And at the same point in time, you've also been on chat shows and made people laugh. So we are hoping that in this case, it's the latter, because it is a very light-hearted show called Kuch Toh Corona. And welcome on season 2 of the show. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, thank you very much for having me. It's very exciting. It's also extremely hot and I won't be able to think straight for very long. And I'm constantly complaining about the heat because it's really hot right now.
So Neha, let me ask you one thing. It's very hot right now, and also another thing is, it's for us, it's a big occasion because we have somebody like you. But for you, I am sure you've been on chat shows and on every, you've achieved almost everything there is to when it comes to Bollywood. But have you been on a show which is so exclusive? And how does it feel to be on a show that is so exclusive that no sponsor wants to even touch the show?
Oh yeah, I've been around enough and more people stating it differently.
How is it quarantine treating you?
Oh, it's treating me well. I feel like, you know, everybody works every day of their life towards building this love nest, which is kind of, you know, with your family or with the people you love or with your friends or whoever you live with. And, you know, we get so consumed with going out and building this love nest that we stop enjoying it. And here I am. I'm sitting here day and night, making sure that I'm around them, you know, surviving on, like they say, necessities and lots of love and fresh air. Like, you know, literally like the good old songs and like the good old times. Like, yeah, and you've got to focus on the positive. I'm not saying this because I'm on, you know, a chat and I need to say the right things. But literally the only thing that's keeping me going is the fact that, you know, I've kind of surrounded myself with, you know, the people I love the most. And the most important thing is just positivity, because there's no other way of getting past this.
So, no, I surrounded myself also with people who I thought loved me, which is my family. But in the first 2-3 days, they were very happy seeing me. After the first 2-3 days, then they said, now we wish the lockdown doesn't continue.
You must be that annoying guy who must be on his phone, either hustling towards an interview or doing an interview. So this is really no good. If your folks are around, they'd be like, you know, you sip lunch khane or dinner khane or breakfast khane aa jata hai table pe, baki kuch karta nahi hai. So that's why they want to throw you out, and I don't blame them.
So the lesson in this for me is that I need to spend more time with my family without the phone. Is it that you are old? Do you also spend days without social media and without the phone? Is it?
Yes, I have very strict timings when it comes to the phone, because I have a daughter who's very young and very impressionable, and she needs eyes, hands, legs, everything. Like, you know, I have to be like that, focused around my child, because she switches from being, you know, extremely happy in a situation to going completely nuts because she doesn't get something like you know, a small, like her stuffed toy, which is a cat. And then if she doesn't get kitty, then we have a problem. And then there's a tantrum. And then there is, you know, attention. And then there's tons of work that
but
needs to
I
be
would,
done.
I would be petrified to throw a tantrum in front of you. Has she come to realize that her mother can be also very strict?
Oh, no. I'm not strict or unreasonable. If the person in front of me is wonderful and kind and bright and intelligent and smart and witty and, yeah, these few qualities are required. But if you're none of the above and if you're annoying, then yeah. And she's not. I love her. So she hasn't seen that side of me.
So basically, I want to know
that for some strange reason, there's been divine intervention and the comments are frozen.
And the comments are frozen?
Yeah. I may want to refresh this.
Listen, I can see all the comments. Everyone sending love struck, please let her only talk, you don't speak. everyone's just praising, and in fact, a few comments are...
It's very hard to believe that the times that we're living in and the times that I'm living in, especially, that people are saying only nice things.
You know, but what you touched upon is a subject which I think the entire nation loves, which is your daughter. So I don't think when it comes to that, there is unanimous love across.
Well, I'm hoping so. As long as, like, you know, there's me, and I just feel like I love her enough for like an entire planet and a universe and galaxy. And oh my God, I cannot begin to tell you. I'm crazy about my daughter. Like when she goes to bed, I'm just like, what do I do with my life now? It takes me like 20 minutes to like get myself back from like mommy mode to like get into work mode and reply emails. And, you know, because she goes to bed by about 8 o'clock and it's story time starting very soon. In the next 20 minutes is when story time starts. So right now she's out having dinner with daddy. So yeah, that's why I have time with you.
But that's very, very kind, very grateful that all of us are, that you are removing time. So tonight is which story, if I may, on a lighter note, tonight.
That's also because you're so annoying. You send so many messages that I was just like, you know, the only way to get him off my back is going to be block him or then just to do this. And you have this mega following and big ups to like leading people from the youth. And I love that. I love the youth. I'm a big flag bearer when it comes to the youth. And you guys are big flag bearers when it comes to the nation. And taking it forward and all of that. And I could mean this from the bottom of my heart. And that's why I was thinking it's very important to talk to you guys. And the best way to do it is through this annoying guy.
I don't ever test your patience because you've used annoying 6 times in once. I'm never going to test your patience. But I'm very grateful that we managed to chase you onto the show. But let me hit.
But what makes you think you're not doing it already?
So there was... But let me
I think what's testing my patience more than anything else is your network. It is terrible.
Listen, I promise there are towers that are right next to my house. But sometimes, for some strange reason, they stop and they don't function. That also could be because I'm not on Reliance Jio and I'm one of the last surviving members of the Airtel family. But let me ask you the pertinent question. What is the biggest upside and the positive from quarantine apart from family time?
Apart from family time, I'm glad you mentioned because I would have gone on a mush trail again. But apart from family time, the big ups is that there's some, there are actually quite a few. I've not set my alarm in I don't know how long. I haven't heard the sound of my alarm. I haven't been stuck in traffic. I haven't had to wear makeup at all. I hate wearing makeup. I haven't worn a pair of jeans. I don't like wearing jeans. I like wearing pajamas most of the time. So I haven't worn stilettos. I don't like doing that. Clearly, you know that, you know, if I were to be left at my state, I would only be walking around in pajamas all day. I love a lot of people that I'm acquainted to and friendly with, but there's some of them who are annoying, and I don't have to have any run-ins with those people. No errands outside, none whatsoever. What else?
So no errands outside. So who does all the grocery shopping, if I may? So has your husband?
No. By errands, I mean like drop off the dry cleaning, pick it up, or like, you know, there's this one place and then you take a left from there and then you go there and can you pick this up for me on the way from here? None of that stuff. So yeah. But yeah, the sort of necessities are all being like, you know, taken care of between Angad and me. So yeah, we're in it. It's not like we're not in, like, no errands means like no basics also. No. We're doing that.
No, but
afternoon naps. Now I don't take afternoon naps, but I'm a big sort of 9-minute napper. Like I get my 40 wings and it's exactly 9 minutes. And every day at about like 3:45, wherever I am, I'd be like tears rolling down my eyes for 9 minutes because I'm just like, I need this nap. And no hesitation, no guilt whatsoever. Those 9 minutes are taken in for sure.
In my case, when I try the 9 minute, when I try the power naps, I start with a power nap, but I only get up 2 hours later. So is this an alarm?
I feel like in my case, it functions. I have a twitch after 9 minutes and I'm like, okay, I'm powered up and I'm ready to go and I'm going to take on the world. But here I just take that 9 minute nap with my daughter sleeps for about 2 hours in the afternoon. But as far as you're concerned, I'm sorry, man. Like 2 hours is God. Like only people who are very, very fortunate can sleep for such long hours, you know, through the day, through lockdown and through like, you know, when life is back to normal. So I'm happy. I'm happy that, you know, you're living it up.
I'm not living it up. My parents don't want me to participate in the household chores. So it's more that and less living it up. But let me take you to the second part of what we do. It's called Tum Bhi Karona. Any one advice that to young people at large who are going to be watching this and who watch it? Of what they can do.
I'm so glad you asked me this. There's so much you can do during quarantine. You know, like the thing is that a lot of people sitting out there thinking that ab main kya karun, ab main to bahar jata tha, main ye TikTok video banata tha, ye main Facebook pe hota tha, or I'd be on like YouTube or Twitter or whatever interests you, or Instagram, and whatever form of social media interests you, ki main vines banata tha, ye, I used to do all this stuff, and now I can't go out, do any DIY kind of video, accumulate data. Content is king. It's exactly what you are also doing right now. So apply yourselves, you know, in your own entertaining way, create content to just like put the message out there. What is the need of the hour? Washing your hands, social distancing, you know, just making sure when you step out, you wear masks all the time. And, you know, all these things are so important. And I feel that such a large population of our country is the youth. And we're in 2020. If you're not out there applying yourself or using your voice or saying the right things or at least joining some sort of movement and believing in something and going ahead with it, then, you know, there's something seriously wrong, because you've got to look inward. You have to look inward and be like, oh, not sit over there, ab kya kare, staring at the ceiling. Kitna kuch hai karne ko yaar. When we were 18 and 19 and 20 and 21, we did not have this phone and we couldn't put ourselves out there. We had to wait for things to happen to us, but we would create it. It's not like, you know, luck is sort of opportunity plus a preparation. So be prepared, because your time is going to come. It's not going to happen in the next 4 weeks. It's not going to happen in the next 8 weeks. But 8 weeks, that's eight extra weeks to prepare yourself for what's to come your way. And the way to prepare is put yourself out there, put a message out there, get better. I read online, Harvard is giving, like, you know, there's 60 courses online that are for free right now.
64 or 67 courses that they're giving for free.
Yes. So whatever interests you, whether it's fashion design or whatever interests you, whether it's something online or whether it's getting interested in tech, a lot of people say, yaar, ye toh ho jayega, tech nahi hoga. But because of a lockdown and the whole world is on lockdown, tech has become easy and user friendly. So don't look for an excuse. Don't say mere paas time nahi hai. Don't say any. I know enough and more people who are out there doing errands working at home, doing errands at home, looking after kids, putting up videos, doing everything that it takes. So, you know, this is not, it's as bad or as good as you make it out to be.
Understood. So it's all in your mind. So If it's a glass half full or a glass half empty?
For me?
No, I'm saying just generally the way to look at it is glass half full, yes, or glass half empty.
Yeah. Yes. And even if, like, this is an old saying, but even if the glass is half empty, you can fill it up with amazing things.
No, but and like you rightly said, and it's not just Harvard, but it's also the hard work that you put in today that will bear fruits tomorrow, especially for young people.
Yeah. If you want to, like, there enough and more, if there's, you know, if you're not going out, then obviously understand that you work, do some amazing work. There are enough and more companies out there or sponsors out there who are looking to collaborate. Look for collaborations. Collaborate with cool people. Get one guy to write some cool stuff. Get another guy to do tech for you. You know, get yourself together. Put your talent out there. Whatever it takes. Like,
that's,
you know,
that's exactly what we did by chasing you.
Yeah.
That's bad.
4 WhatsApp messages, 18 calls to me and my manager.
No, no, but I'm, like I said, I'm
no, but I'm loving it. You are not annoying. I'm just saying annoying because I want to trouble you. You are not annoying. You're very sweet. And I really want to tell your parents not to throw you out of your house because you're extremely charming. Sorry, extremely charming. And at least to keep you in till the 3rd of May, unless the lockdown gets extended, I'll put an appeal for you. Especially.
Well, thank you. So sweet. And my mother and father, see, they follow you regularly. They're one of the few Bollywood people that they actually follow regularly. Both on Twitter and Instagram, they say that there are very few people who speak their heart, and there is one person who speaks her heart more than anybody else when it comes to the fraternity. But
that sounds like trouble.
No, but you are an inspiration, and you really are a role model for young people. Let me take you to the final part of what I need to ask you before taking just 2 questions from the audience. The last part is called 21-day lockdown. And what I want to ask you are not 21 questions. What I want to ask you are just 2 or 3 very rapid-fire questions, which I would like you to answer honestly.
Okay.
In your house, who's the one who makes maximum decisions?
Me.
If there is one thing that you would want, one profession, apart from acting, producing, directing, being a chat show host, that you would take up as a full-time profession, which one would that be?
It's not a full-time profession, but I'd like to, like, you know, someday, I know it comes with its own stress and all of that, but Angad and me both would like to have, like, boutique hotels in, like, small towns and, you know, go into the interiors of India and explore and open, like, you know, little boutique hotels. It's very strange, but yeah, we want to do that.
I don't think it's strange at all. In fact, the concept of boutique hotels in itself is, I think, something that is super, because boutique hotels give you the best of, they have the luxury, but at the same point in time, you get an experience like no other. So I'm a huge fan of all boutique hotels, and given a chance, if you open
one. So if you open one, you must come. By then, your show will do extremely well. Not to say it's not doing very, really well. And then you'll not say ki sponsor nahi hai, and you can pay us lots of money and come and shoot there.
Absolutely. But this is something that keeps me busy, and I'm absolutely loving the opportunity to talk to people such as you. But let me ask you one final question before we open it to 2 questions from the audience.
Yes, go ahead.
So it's $1 million question, and on winning this, we transfer $1 million Zimbabwean to your bank account.
No need for that.
but tell me, the nation wants to know, if Neha Dhupia would get a chance to join politics, which political party, or if you make rather the choice to join politics, because I'm sure politicians would love to have you, but which political party would you join?
Oh, I've never even thought about it, but I'm not very, you know, as hard to believe as it may sound, I'm actually not very inclined towards politics, and I'm the kind of person who says it as it is. So I don't beat around the bush. So I'm not fully clued in with the practice of it. A and B, I think that our political parties, where they stand and with the leaders that we have, especially in the way the quarantine's been handled, they're doing a fine job, and it's best to keep me away from any political party.
So you are just another Aam Aadmi like me, with no connection to any Aam Aadmi party or any other political party.
I am just another citizen of India.
Understood. Very, very politically correct. And now there are 2 questions I want to ask you from on behalf of the people who are watching this, all your fans who've come here to watch you.
Go ahead.
First, the first question is, what would you do to tackle coronavirus if you were in charge?
If I was in charge?
For a week. How would you tackle?
Oh man, I would. I don't know what I would do, but I feel that just screaming from rooftops exactly what our government is doing, state and central government is doing right now. I mean, till we don't have a cure, washing hands, lockdown, social distancing, using masks, just all the measures that they're taking. There are like some amazing things. Like I was reading up about how Delhi's handling it. It's fantastic. Even here in our neighborhood in Mumbai, in Maharashtra, in Bandra, I know the numbers are high, but they have really been controlled and they could have been way worse. So I don't think I could have done a better job than what our leaders are doing right now.
Perfect. Your second question, what's your definition of feminism?
I mean, just to be like... I mean, a lot of people like have this thing about feminism and woman empowerment and all of that. I just feel like we are no one when it comes to empowering women. We should enable them, and that's as far as we can go, and encourage them to do all the things that they want to do. And wherever we see that we can provide opportunity or a helping hand, and there have been times that I've reached out to people and people have reached out to me. Yeah, so we're in this together. But I mean, for me, it's more than feminism, more than women empowerment, it's just enabling women.
And I think looking at you, a lot of people find inspiration and want to be even further enabled. How difficult is it being a Bollywood mother? Because this is what you're going to do immediately after this. So I wanted to ask you this question, like, how difficult is this job?
Oh, it's adorable. It's 2 minutes to story time. It's just so wonderful. I'm getting into it with the same book because of lockdown. I can't buy new books. So my friend Nikhil Chinnappa told me, just open the same book, but make up a new story. So yeah, I'm 2 minutes away from making up many stories. So it's great. And she looks at me with wonderment in her eyes. And then she waits. And then finally she says, Nini. And I'm like, yay, she's falling off to sleep. So she knows Nini now.
Oh, how nice. And that's the most poetic note. I think everybody who's on the show wishes that they could see something like that in person. I think she's the most adorable thing that I think the entire nation loves her. But at the same point in time, another person that the nation loves has taken up time and has spent time with us. So I'm very grateful that in this season of coronavirus, that we've got time to have you come and interact with Young India on IMN Officials Kuch Toh Corona. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It was wonderful talking to you. You're not annoying. You're amazing. My love to you, all the followers. A big shout out to the youth. And you guys are going to take us forward. There's no other way. And yeah, make sure it's 2020 and use your voice.
I'll make one confession before you go. I usually don't get intimidated before talking to a guest. I was very intimidated because I've seen you a couple of times on roadies, and I've seen when you get angry, the kind of reactions that you give. And also with my parents following you on Twitter and other mediums, I know how vocal you are. So I was thinking in my head, what should I say and what should I not say? I think at the end of the show, this has been one of my most fun, easygoing episodes up until now. So
that is exactly what you should say, and that's a great sign off. And do not be scared or intimidated by me. I am now this is a trick situation because I can't say I'm wonderful and I can't say anything else, but I can only say one thing.
You are wonderful.
That I'm delighted to be on your show. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And my love to everyone. Check it. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.